But I realized what that look in their eye was back then. It was fear. It was fear of, you know, I mean, I had witnessed, you know, firsthand things that would, you know, destroy this city, you know, people or the position, you know what I mean? It's not going to be believed, they said. It will not be believed. You will be found guilty of perjury, and you, I mean, they weren't telling me maybe. You know, they were saying, there's no way. You go on with this story, you're going to jail. I mean, that was said to me direct.
Information presented to the foster care review board, either via the telephone reports, the personal reports, or the reports we reviewed, Mary King's name was consistently present as someone that the youth were making allegations against. I would say we handed over at least a foot high amount of material to authorities, and nothing happened. For me, it was very clear that the case was not investigated and not pursued because of the alleged perpetrators.
But King's extravagance attracted the attention of the Internal Revenue Service. As a result, on April 11, 1988, the Franklin Credit Union was raided and closed by the FBI. King was arrested, and the federal investigation showed he had stolen $40 million from Franklin. Documents we possess reveal the FBI interviewed many of the victims of Larry King's sex ring, but no action was taken. No action was taken. No action was taken. No action was taken. No action was taken.